Welcome back to the channel. My name is Colton, also known as Nerd Designer. Thank you, thank you, thank you for clicking on today's video. We are finally,
finally
done doing Star Wars Photoshop content with this week's poster for Ahsoka, premiering right now on Disney Plus. I'll be walking you through how I made this poster and some of my thoughts on the show as a whole. If you haven't seen any of my other Star Wars content, I've made a playlist up in the corner. Feel free to check that out and then come back. After this, we're going to be switching up and doing something new, and we're going to be making some album covers for some of my favorite albums. I'm super excited to make that video for you guys, so remember to like, subscribe, and hit that bell button so you're notified next week when that video drops. If you want a sneak peek, it's on my TikTok or my Instagram. They're already there if you want to see kind of what's going on. But for right now, we are focused on Ahsoka.
It's the moment that you've been waiting for.
Let's open up Photoshop and get goddamn started. So jumping right in, the first thing we always do is cut out the character. This has only gotten easier as time has gone on with AI tools. I don't really even need to use the pen tool anymore to get a crisp, clean cutout of a character. There's a little bit of touch-ups you need to do here and there as you see fit using a marquee tool. And then with the select and mask button, boop.
Stop it. Get some help.
You're done. It's super, super easy.
It's not easy doing what I do, is it?
My goal for this poster was to kind of match what they've been showing in the trailers, where there's this lightsaber battle going on in this kind of dome star map, blue and gray, hazy thing. I just like the color palette that's behind her while her white lightsabers are contrasting to that background. I just think it's really cool, and I think it fits with the marketing. So I went with a gradient, just trying to do blue, muted tones, dark gray, kind of a muted charcoal to like a cobalt blue. And then I tried to add a star map and a galaxy behind her just to kind of make it feel more Star Wars-ish.
You're ugly, you are disgusting, I'm gonna kill you, give me $200.
Fuck, I'm so sick of talking about Star Wars.
Ah, Star Wars, nothing but Star Wars, give me the Star Wars.
After I kind of got the background nailed down and Ahsoka in place, I kind of wanted to go a different approach and step out of my usual style and just put shapes in this bitch.
Why would you say that?
My stomach is just...
I just wanted to put like circles and star maps and lines. I think that back light like highlights over her, around her head thing.
I'm very aroused right now.
I too am aroused.
I'm starting to swell up.
Really well. It doesn't make sense at all, but most posters don't. I purposely went a little bit more simple with this poster. I feel like I have a tendency to overdo it, over design, and kind of vomit all over the canvas, and then everything just becomes noise and you get lost in the sauce.
man, a bitch gonna get lost in the sauce, man.
Mm-hmm. Cut the bullshit and just focus on Ahsoka. There's not a whole lot of design in terms of big picture stuff for me to tell you about. Thank you. So let's move on to talking about the show.
Are you sure about that?
I have three or four main points. I think the show is good on the whole. I think it's worth it to watch if you're a Star Wars fan. I definitely think it's better than Kenobi.
That shit was ass.
In terms of visual style, polish, story, I think the volume is far less frequently used. And when it is used, it's not as blatantly apparent that they're just standing in a circular room. I think the show is gorgeous. It looks great. The visual effects are amazing. The costumes, the characters on a TV show budget, it's pretty fucking impressive. Having said that.
Oh shit, here we go again.
I do think the first two episodes are a little slow. And my barometer for whether something's interesting or not is whether or not I feel the urge to check my phone. If I don't feel that urge and I can make it through a whole episode of something, you've hooked me. And if I'm checking my phone, I'm just not feeling it. And so those first two episodes were spinning their wheels a little bit, but hopefully the payoff in the back half is worth sitting through the first two. The third episode, it's 30 minutes long. And there's always fucking something. It like ended and I just, whatever. Nitpicks aside, I think it's good. There's some lulls in the first two. The third one picks it up and I am very optimistic for the rest of it. Like I said, because this is such a simple poster and such a simple design, there's not really much for me to do to finish it out. The camera raw filter got me like 99% of the way there, especially using the classic clarity bar, thanks Benny, all the way up to really add some of that crunch to it, then just kind of playing with the colors and feeling around. After I finished with the camera raw filter, I just put an oil paint filter on the top like I do everything else. I feel like it just kind of smooths out at a distance all the noise in a poster when everything's kind of piled on each other. You can start to see this visual noise. And if that's not intentional, it's distracting. And so the oil paint, I think with high fidelity character posters and high res images really just does a lot of work to kind of smooth that out and make it feel more professional and polished. And that is my attempt at a poster for the Ahsoka series on Disney Plus. I really enjoy how this one turned out. It's significantly simpler than my other designs, but I think that's a net benefit overall. And I'm really proud of how this could kind of just slide in with the other advertising from Disney. They gave such strong photography and character posters to start with that I can just slide right in with my little design and nobody would ever know that it's some dude sitting in his fucking apartment. Let me know down below in the comments what you think of this poster and how you feel about the show, whether you agree or disagree with how I feel about it. As the summer comes to a close and we go back to school and there's no big releases anymore, what would you like to see me design stuff for? It could be anything. Please let me know. I'm always looking for ideas. And remember, I love you almost as much as people in Star Wars like getting stabbed in the gut. Stay sexy, bye.